The Smelly Unicorn by Natasha Desborough, read by Julie Hesmondalgh.
Right by the oak tree in the deep, dark wood, in amongst the fairies, a glaring dragon stood. He was fierce and gigantic, with rough purple scales, sharp pointed teeth, and two thrashing tails. The fairies all asked, "Tell us what you do. We know you're a dragon, but what's magic about you?" The fierce dragon cried out,
"Well, I'm sure you don't suppose that I can breathe out fire from the nostrils of my nose."
The fairies were impressed, and all of them agreed that a fire-breathing dragon was most magical indeed. Pleased with himself, the dragon gave a grin. He knew in his heart that he'd be the one to win. In all of the woods, the north, west, south, and east, he would be the one named the most magical beast. Right by the elm tree in the deep, dark wood, in amongst the fairies, a grumpy goblin stood. His nose looked like a sausage. He wasn't very tall. His ears were big and pointy, and he had no hair at all. The fairies all asked, "Tell us what you do. We know you're a goblin, but what's magic about you?" The grumpy goblin grumbled,
"My magic power is clear. By waggling my ears like this, I can just disappear."
The fairies were delighted, and all of them agreed that a disappearing goblin was most magical indeed. Pleased with himself, the goblin gave a grin. He knew in his heart that he'd be the one to win. In all of the woods, the north, west, south, and east, he would be the one named the most magical beast. Right by the ash tree in the deep, dark wood, in amongst the fairies, a shy unicorn stood. With a horn on her head and shining eyes so bright, a long flowing mane and fur snowy white, the fairies all asked,
"Tell us what you do. We know you're a unicorn, but what's magic about you?"
The shy unicorn said, "There is nothing I can do. To say that I am magic is completely untrue." The fairies were confused, but all of them agreed that this shy unicorn seemed most magical indeed. Sad and quite alone, the creature didn't grin. She knew in her heart that she didn't want to win. In all of the woods, the north, west, south, and east, she didn't want to be named the most magical beast. But the goblin and the dragon wouldn't let it rest. They both wanted to find out which magic beast was best. So they held a competition where the three beasts would compete to impress the fairy judges with their special magic feat. The goblin and the dragon were competitively keen, but the unicorn, so frightened, found her white fur turned pale green. Her tummy started bubbling. It churned until she started feeling dizzy and began to feel quite ill. The dragon stepped up first with his massive nostrils flared, and a jet of fire shot out fast, which left the fairies scared. The fairies were impressed, and all of them agreed that a fire-breathing dragon was most magical indeed. The goblin flapped his ears so fast, he began to look quite weird. But when the fairies looked again, he'd completely disappeared. The fairies were delighted, and all of them agreed that a goblin who could vanish was most magical indeed. But the unicorn was frightened, and she really felt so sick. The fairies shouted, "Hurry up! We want you to be quick!" Her throat was feeling dry, so she gave a little cough. Then her bottom gave a shudder, and she did a big blow-off. The noise was quite enormous, and all the fairies jumped. Everyone was shocked that the unicorn had trumped. But the smell that started drifting up into the sky was really quite delicious. The scent of strawberry pie. The fairies were amazed, and all of them agreed that a smelly unicorn was most magical indeed. The unicorn went red. and gave a little grin. The fairies all declared that she was the one to win. In all of the woods, the north, west, south and east, the unicorn was the one they called the most magical beast.